Where the hell are people, man? Am I audible? Can somebody just tell me? Am I audible right now? Please do let me know if I'm audible or not. Hello, am I audible? Hello guys, can you please tell me if I'm audible or not? अरे मुझे सुन सकते हो भाई, बताओ यार। ओके फाइन फाइन। सो हाई एवरीबडी, आई होप एवरीबडी इज लाइक डूइंग फाइन एंड यू आर हैविंग अ ग्रेट टाइम। सर राम राम, राम राम भाई जी, राम राम, यू आर ऑडिबल। थैंक यू थैंक यू थैंक यू सो मच वैशाली। सो एज वी डिसाइडेड, वी आर लाइव अगेन एंड एज यू ऑल गाइज लाइक हैव सीन ऑन माई स्टोरीज दैट यू नो टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ लाइव डिस्कशन विद वैशाली। And Vaishali is somebody who is a full-time corporate professional and like with over more than 4+ years of experience in finance, and she's also a personality development and development coach and trainer as well. She is somebody who likes to talk about, you know, so many varied subjects like mental health, relationships and much more. So today we'll have a discussion with her. So let's see if she is available right now. Hi Vaishali, can you please send me a request to join the live session, please? Because there is no option to, you know, send you a notification or a request for joining the live session. Vaishali, are you there?
I think there is a glitch. Let me just solve it.
Hi.
Hi, hi Vaishali, how are
Finally,
you?
Vipin, we are at it. I'm great. I'm great. Hi, hello everyone. Good evening. I can see a lot of
Good
people
evening.
at it already. Good evening,
There
everyone.
are some of them here available. So, how
Some
are
of
you
them,
doing?
yeah. I'm great. I'm great. I was just trying to, connect with in a live video through my laptop, but I think that wasn't given an option, so I had to do it from my mobile only.
Yeah, it is available. It is available in phone, I guess.
I
I don't
think
know about the
so. I think
laptop,
so.
but
Yep. Because on laptop, I wasn't getting an option to send you a request either. So, how's the evening going on? How's the weekend so far, Vipin? Good to see you
Amazing,
after a long
amazing.
time. Great,
Same
great,
here, same
great.
here. It was amazing, it was amazing. And all day long, I was just waiting for this moment to come.
For this
Like
session to.
we have been like talking about this, and we were planning
Yeah.
to do this live session from a very long time. So
Yeah, it
I
was
was like
pending
looking
for
forward to
a
it.
long time. Yeah, it was under our pipeline for a long time. So I think a lot of people are waiting and they must be curious to know that why
Yeah,
we both are going live.
first of all, I would like you if you could just tell something about yourself to
Oh,
people.
that's so
Sure,
generous
sure.
of you, Vipin. So talking about
Sure.
myself, I'm a full-time corporate professional, as Vipin already stated. Apart from this, I'm a certified trainer and coach. So my niche is in personality development and image. But apart from this, I like to talk about a lot of different subject matters, like for example, mental health, or we can talk about lifestyle, we can talk about work
Yes.
ethics. So being a very curious and a person who is having an interest in this area, I thought of taking this up as a collaborating with people and doing live with them one by one. So Vipin was on my list, and talking about him, he's an amazing artist, a great creative
Thank you.
director, and I think I would say an amazing conversationalist person as well, because he's full of ideas and thoughts. So I just don't need to introduce him, I think, to the audiences. People
Well,
are
thank you
already
so
big
much.
fan of you.
Thank you. No, not at all. Well, thank you so much for using those lovely words for me.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. So we would just like to give a brief introduction why we are going live with each other at this time. We guys are not
Yes.
therapists, first of all. We guys are not mental health
Yeah, this is like
counselors. So
the big
whatever.
disclaimer here.
Exactly. So this
Yeah.
is like a pep talk which we're going to do, and we will just be taking talking casually about factors which might impact our overall health, financial, physical, emotional.
Right.
But we are not here to give you any sort of a comments or any sort of a suggestion. So do not take it like we are counselors, so we are here to give you suggestions, and we are not here to even tell somebody how to make them feel good during pandemic or COVID. This is just a key
Casual
takeaway
talk
session,
between those between
casual
two people.
talk between us. Yeah, so it's going to be a pep talk, so that's the biggest disclaimer. We really want to do it before only, because I've seen a lot of people doing that on social media, and
Right.
then people following it without actually knowing what's best for them and what's not best for
Right,
them.
right, right. Right. We are not
Right, and
professionals. We are just
also,
talking about something that we are
exactly,
interested in talking about,
I think we have
and then
great,
it's
great plan.
like yeah, it's completely on to other people what they really want to,
But they
inculcate in their
really,
own lives. That's completely up to them.
exactly.
Yeah.
So that's that was something we really wanted to disclose as a disclaimer and give you an introduction before. So Vipin, let's begin with this session now. I think it's already 7:05. People might be waiting now. Okay.
Right.
So Vipin, I just wanted, yeah. Go ahead,
No,
please.
please go on, please go on, please go on.
Yeah. Vipin, I just wanted to understand what is your regime, or maybe what do you do when you feel negative thoughts, or you understand that your mind is inculcating negative thoughts, however you are avoiding them. So what exactly do you do at that moment, and what are the signs which come to your mind as a first? If you would just like to highlight these things and maybe throw some light on this.
Yeah, sure. First of all, I would like to say that, I don't know why people think of negative thoughts as, some sort of bad things. I mean, it's completely normal. We all feel negative thoughts, every now and then.
Of
And
course.
If I have to like tell you about my own personal life, there used to be a time when whenever these thoughts used to come in my mind, I used to go blank and I used to feel depressed. But one thing that I would say, changed in me over these years is that now I don't take them seriously at all. I mean, if there is like
Right.
I'm feeling low, if I'm feeling low and I'm not, getting that kind of focus on towards my work, I just take a
Right.
break. And I just, sometimes I watch movies, good movies, or I basically read books. Most of the times I spend like reading books only. So these are my things that I do whenever I feel low. So I don't take, there was a time, like I said, when I used to, take these things very seriously and I used to go on internet and I used to search these things on internet. Why am I feeling like this? And why exactly I'm going through this? And why the hell has God like, put me into this situation? Why only me? So these were the questions that used to like, revolve in my head at that time. But
Revolve around your heart. Yeah.
completely. But over the years, as the time went by, I learned these things that, it's perfectly normal. We all go through such things. And seeing the contemporary scenario, the current scenario of, the world we live in, like with constant pressures from all around ourselves and with constant comparison that we see around ourselves, it's perfectly normal. So what I do is I just take a break from my work and I just watch movies, read good books, listen to good people like you. And there are other people as well whom like I love to hear those, I mean their words, whatever they are speaking. So that's what I do. I mean, completely normal.
That's great. That's great. Because I think we all have something which we try to do whenever we feel down, or maybe when we are trying to tune our negative thoughts into positive. So mine would be reading books, as you said, yeah. But then I try to look for an interesting piece of a work which has been done by an amazing artist, or maybe an interesting piece of an article which can really tune my mood into positive thing. And apart from that, I like to do something whichever makes me happy, be it giving sessions, be it talking with people. I'm an extrovert personality, so I really like to talk to different people, and I like knowing them from the core of my heart. And even if I'm doing training, coaching, or even if I'm talking at a one-on-one level as well, like as I said, that I'm a full-time professional, corporate professional as well. So I do meet a lot of people, and being that in my personality, I'd like to try to avoid those negative thoughts and try to tune them with the best possible ways which are currently available, be it reading, be it doing gardening, watching movies, make creating some good content, going through a fabulous piece of work, as I said. So these are something which I really would like to throw a light on, something which I really do whenever I try to tune my ne negative thoughts into the positive. So Vipin, I just wanted to understand, though we do understand that as a human we just feel negative at times, and we try to tune those negative thoughts into the positive. You really think that modernity, westernization, this is a big reason why we feel burdened at times, so maybe why we feel anxious? Maybe we guys have defined a different way to our success, failure, maybe anything which you would like to, throw some light on. What do you think, being an artist, being a creative
Sure.
director?
Not just, I would say, not just being an artist, I mean being a normal human being, when I see people and when I see the like, the contemporary structure of our society, possibly say the modernity as we are discussing. I mean, this is the central theme of
Modern,
our discussion today as well. So when I
right.
see it, I see a lot of flaws in it, and I would rather go on to say that for me, it's completely my perspective. I could be wrong. You can, correct me if I'm wrong. I personally believe that what if the whole structure is like, whole structure is flawed? Okay. Instead of just finding that what are the, one or two or three, four flaws, what if the whole structure is flawed? I mean, if you look at the how we have been taught right from our childhood, that what exactly is success for us? And now, as with the advent of internet and especially social media, we all have become like, huge actors, I would say. We know how to sound good. We know how to sound cool. We know how to look good. But do we exactly know how to be good? That's the
Exactly.
important question. We know how to do all the good things, but do we know how to be good? And just by looking at the society, I mean, what society, you know, is constantly pressurizing us. And especially I would say that if you look at the modern, I would say the big companies, huge brands, how they are, you know, bombarding us with their latest inventions, and you know how they want to just sell things to us. So basically what they truly want to do is they just want to rob us. They just want to rob our pockets, and they want us to, like, you know, buy new things and, you know, get as many possessions, as many material things as possible. So basically, if we look at very closely, and if we could just imagine it for ourselves, we can say that, is it coming from ourselves? Is it coming from, you know, inside us that, okay, this is what I want to do in my life and this is what I don't want to do in my life? Or are there any third party agencies that are possibly, I would say, brainwashing us in choosing a lifestyle, in choosing a career path, basically, and in choosing whatever things that we are, you know, doing in our lives, basically? That can happen as well. I mean,
right from
our childhood, we have always heard that people always tell us that this is the, you know, standard definition of success. If you're earning this much amount of money, if you have these much amount of resources and these much amount of material possessions, then you're successful. So we all talk about the tangible things that we can see and touch. But what about those intangible things? What about happiness? What about sound sleep? What about good relationships? We don't talk about these things, and we don't inculcate these things in the younger generations as well. We are constantly bombarding with this thing, and everybody on the internet seems to, like, you know, constantly telling us you have to do this, you have to, you know, reach there. If you have not traveled to this place, why haven't you gone to this place? You have to see that place. So it's like, basically, you know, constantly we are getting bombarded with these things, and we always feel anxious. Yaar, ki hum kahin na kahin peeche chhoot rahe hain. कोई हमसे आगे जा रहा है बेसिकली. तो ये सारी चीजें हैं. तो मुझे ये मॉडर्निटी में ना बहुत बड़ा एक फ्लॉ लगता है कि हम सबको ये दिखाना आ गया बेसिकली कि सक्सेस होती क्या है. हम एक्टर बहुत अच्छे बन गए हैं, बट हम इंसान कितने अच्छे बने हैं, दैट इज, यू नो, आई वुड से इज क्वाइट डिबेटेबल.
सो यू नो विपिन, आई थिंक आई एग्री, बिकॉज ऑल द थिंग्स व्हिच यू स्टेटेड दैट मॉडर्निटी हैज अफेक्टेड अस सो बैडली दैट इफ वी हैवंट ट्रैवल्ड टू दैट स्पेसिफिक place, or if we are not into a relationship, if we do not have boyfriend, girlfriends, if we do not have a fancy job, if we don't, we are not a MBA, people start judging their intent. And I think these are parameters which really makes us anxious. And not anxious, I would say, I think more insecure in the public as
true,
well.
True. The moment that would be the right word, yes.
The moment we go for an interview, if we see that we do not have MBA, but there is someone else who has done that MBA and has a more experience than us, we start judging and comparing us. So I think this is the main root. This is in us. This is what we are.
True.
The one who allow comparison, and comparison is the root of the judgment. As you stated, the moment I would start comparing myself to someone physically, financially, career-wise, I would start deteriorating myself there and then only.
That's
in terms
true.
Of health,
Rightly
in
said.
Terms of everything, be it financial,
everything.
Emotional, everything. So I think we need to understand this thing that we do not need to allow ourselves to be comparable with someone else. We need to understand that we all have our own individuality. So we need to respect that. We need to respect that. I may not be as successful as someone who is now, maybe in my field, but you never know what things turn out to be, you know, in a coming 5 to 6 years. So I think this is what, if we allow someone to hurt ourselves, if we allow someone to judge us, if we allow someone to make us feel insecure, there and then people do. And we don't realize it, we get into the toxic relationship. And it is just not personal, it is at work as well. We don't realize how many toxic relationships we have at our workplace as well. There could be a lot of people who are not, who may not be very happy, may not be very, I would say, content for our success, and it could be that we are avoiding and we are treating them as our friends, but we need to start realizing the signs of toxic relationship at work and in personal life, and also how we can mitigate it so that we do not allow someone to actually hurt us and come back to us.
Very rightly said.
Hi, Priyanka. I see a lot of people joining from my community. Good to see everyone. Vanita, Yush, good evening, everyone. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, you know, Vipin, as you stated that we have talked about that comparison is the root for a lot of things which impact.
And
so maybe
one thing, I would like to add one thing here. If we have to like compare ourselves, why not compare ourselves with like what we were 5 years down the line? I mean,
exactly.
5 years
exactly.
ago. Why don't we compare ourselves with, I mean, let's say if I was like at point A 2 years back, at least now I am at point B. So I can compare myself with myself. If I have to constantly, you know, seek out other people to compare myself just to feel good about myself or just to make myself feel superior or either inferior, that's what comparisons do. When somebody is like up the ladder in comparison to us, we feel insecure and we start feeling inferior at the same time. So instead of like, I would say, you know, seeking out people to compare yourself, why not compare yourself with yourself? Yeah.
Exactly.
Because there will always be people. There will always be people who are doing better than you, who are richer than you, who are smarter than you, who look beautiful than you. So what will you do? Where will you find that happiness?
मुझे एक प्रोवर्ब याद आया अभी जो तुमने बोला है द बेस्ट पर्सन हु रियली लव्स यू इज द वन यू एक्चुअली सी इन अ मिरर एवरी डे सो वी नीड टू थिंक टू आवरसेल्फ दैट द बेस्ट पर्सन हु रियली लव अस इज द ओनली पर्सन वी सी इन द मिरर एंड दैट्स व्हाई इफ वी रियली वांट टू कंपेयर वी नीड टू कंपेयर आवरसेल्फ विद व्हाट वी वर एंड वेयर वी हैव बीन बिकॉज ट्रस्ट मी दिस जर्नी वाजंट इजी And I think the journeys are never easy for anyone. So we need to recognize initially only at the potential. We sometimes, you know, struggle and I believe people fail to understand the potential they have.
Right.
They think that they cannot make to that point wherever they think they have defined their success. But then there are a lot of points where they think that they do not have the potential, but then they have a lot of potential towards it. So this modernity part is that the moment we step into the corporate world, we start comparing ourselves to other people with the first of all package. We are at the lower package than other people. Then the second thing would be we see someone, going around with someone. We start comparing, what we do not have a life. I see a lot of people commenting, oh, you are single, don't have a boyfriend, you have no life, you are not enjoying at all. Who are they to actually comment and I would say to define what is, how am I enjoying my life and how I am not enjoying my life? First of all,
I mean, who are you? Who are you to basically judge?
Who are you to judge us?
You don't know at all.
If someone who is not having a boyfriend and a girlfriend, this is, I think, the need. This has become a need of a modernity, and this has led to a lot of suicide as well. Why people indulge themselves into suicide? I see a lot of young people making suicides because of a breakup, and they even don't realize, even if they were in love or not. I mean. That commitment, I think it's very hard to actually be sure of whether you really love that person or not. So what are your views around this? Like the stigma which is going around and especially the fear of flings, relationship or maybe the comparisons between millennials actually suffer a lot. Oh, tumhara package kitna hai for everything, you know. We are trying to see someone or maybe, okay, you don't know this or you don't know that. So what exactly you would like to say about this point, you know?
Well, you know, as far as comparisons are concerned, I really don't believe in comparisons at all. I mean, I would say a few years back, I was that kind of a person who always used to compare myself. And that's why, you know, I always used to wonder why I have such negative thoughts in my mind. And years later, I realized that the only reason was my own thinking. I was comparing myself constantly with other people. I mean, let's say, I'll give you an example. If you would have contacted me like 2 years or 3 years back and you would have asked me for doing this live session, I would have directly said no, because I used to be in that kind of mindset. Always I used to wonder what will happen, you know, if I go out and if I start, you know, having a conversation with the other person, how the other person might judge me, what if I fumble, what if I don't speak good English. So these comparisons, you know, always used to, you know, I used to get overwhelmed with these things, and I used to run away from situations just because of comparisons. But the day I accepted myself, you know, that
exactly.
whatever I am, whoever kind of a person I am, I'm all right with that. I don't have any problem. I am good. You I'm know, doing good with my life. I don't ask for like favors from other people. If I'm doing good in my life, I get to do what I really love doing. I love photography and I do it. That in itself is a huge success for me. Why do I have to constantly compare my, there are hundreds of people who don't get to choose what they want to do. Their parents force them in doing things. But if I am getting, you know, to do what I really love doing, and I've been doing it for like last 6-7 years, that in itself is a huge success for me. Why do I have to compare myself? You know, let's say in photography terms as well, if there is any other photographer who is doing way better than me, it's good for him. It's good for him. I can learn from him. I can improve myself. There is no doubt in that. There is always a possibility of improvement. There is always a room for, like, you know.
Of course.
So you can do that. You can keep on doing that. There is no problem. But the problem starts the moment you start comparing yourself. Now you have started saying that this guy has, you know, this much of resources. I don't have this, these things. So that's the problem. So right now, if I have to like tell you what kind of a mindset I'm in, I don't believe in comparisons at all. Yet.
Vipin, what I feel, it is all, I think it's all wrong in the mindset of people. Yeah. So whatever we're talking about, I think it's all connected to our thought process.
Yeah.
So I am thinking positive, if I am thinking optimistic about things, about my career, about my relationships, and if I'm working and I'm trying to improve them, strengthen themselves to have a purposeful life, which we all need to have, peaceful life, which you said earlier as well. I believe it's all about our mindset. So the moment we control our mind, our emotions, I think that's the best victory we would ever have. Because if we cannot control our mind, our emotions, our mind, emotions will control us. As you said, all this is also psychology. You stated, 2 years ago, I used to think that if I would go out and would have a conversation with someone, that person would judge me. One thing you said. Second thing you stated, that person could judge me if I'm not speaking a good English. If I'm not looking good, or maybe if I do not have a great credentials.
True,
we say nowadays, degree, fancy certifications. Let me put that into a great credentials thing. True. So I have seen this thing that a person who is, I think, who is in a school academics could behave, could speak, could work far better than the person who has a good experience in a corporate environment. Right. So it's all about our mindset, our thought process, and I think our ethics. If we can control our emotions, like as I already stated, that my niche is into personality development and image thing. So when I talk to people, a lot of people face challenges with their confidence level. And that is because nobody has ever told them how amazing they are. Second thing, emotional intelligence. I think it's there's a research led by the Harvard. I think we guys were talking when we met over a coffee previously. So I think we all have heard of the data statistics, which is quite popular on social media as well. So Harvard is the renowned institute, and everyone must be aware about it, even our audiences. They do a lot of research on happiness statistics. And when it comes to happiness index, right? And when we actually do that, and when we actually look at the numbers, we see that how low we are in terms of that, because we guys are always after status symbol.
True,
I think more of a demographic needs, more of a psychographics, rather than what exactly we never think about our behavior, or we never think from our psychographics. So a psychographic needs. So I think we all have heard about Maslow's theory of needs somewhere during our academics. I think we all have been through that. So Vipin, so what exactly, as you stated that you were totally a different person altogether before 2 years than you are now, because I see you a very, very, I think an amazing personality at this time, this moment, and it's always great having your thought opinion. So what exactly you did to control your emotions? If I actually talk about that, okay, I understand that you changed your mindset and you try to tune your negative into positive thoughts by being more optimistic and positive towards life, towards your career, towards everything. What exactly you did, or you tried making an effort towards your emotional health? How you control your emotions?
Well, you know, I've started hanging out with like good people, first of all.
Okay.
Who were like, you know, I used to hang around with people who were like energy suckers, you know, basically. So I started hanging around with good people, and I started, I started finding ways to, you know, channelize my energy. I was always, right from my childhood days, I was always full of questions about everything. Okay. And always confused about so many things. And I always used to find what I can do, how can I say something, because, you know, like you said, you have been an extroverted, you know, person, but I am completely opposite of you. I'm a completely introverted person. I don't go out, you know, in parties. I don't meet people. I don't go to like crowded place. Most of the time I keep myself alone. So it was very hard for me. And it was very hard because I couldn't find people to talk to, and I couldn't find people to share, what I'm thinking and what I'm going through. So one thing, very basic thing, very simple thing is poetry. Poetry, I can't tell you and I can't force how much poetry has, you know, literally helped me in coming out of that phase. I started writing poetry extensively.
Yeah.
So that was one thing that I did, and I still do that from, you know, time to time. So whenever I'm feeling low, what I do is I don't tell these things to people. What I do is I you know, just like this diary, I open a diary, I take out a pen, and I just write whatever the hell I'm feeling, you know, in that moment. And I just write it down on paper. And I can't tell you how much relaxed I feel after doing that.
Exactly.
It's a very simple technique. You know, whenever you feel something, and don't keep it to yourself. Even if you don't have any person around you to share those things, just write it down.
Yeah.
In any form. And I had so many different avenues, you know, like photography is one thing, and writing and poetry is one thing. Then I do so many other things as well. So I started finding ways, and that's how I, you know, coped up with those emotional.
So I think number one thing, and I think one advice which I have heard from a lot of professional coaches as well, in my training classes as well, journaling really helps. So as you stated that you started journaling all the things about everything, whatever you were doing or whatever you were grateful about. So when we talk about journaling, it's one of the amazing things which you could do to improve your emotional health and to control your negative emotions. But in that, when we talk about journaling, we just don't need to think about how we can, we don't need to write just positive things. We also need to capture negative things. Maybe
whatever you're feeling.
Exactly. In a nutshell, I would say blood it badly. Blood it badly on a diary. No matter whatever you felt, blood it badly. So this really helps in capturing your emotions, understanding your tendency of emotions, and how you want to make them. So I tell you what, I have been always a confident and extrovert person throughout my life, and I'm like with Fardine Wali hoon. सो कुछ भी हो जाए एंड आई वुड से दैट इन फ्रंट ऑफ अ लाइव एंड दैट्स ओके इवन इफ दैट कुड बी कैप्चर्ड कंप्लीटली ओके बिकॉज नोबडी हैज अ पावर टू जज एनीवन एंड मेक कमेंट्स ऑन एनीवन एंड नोबडी हैज एवर बी आई वुड से किसी का इतना रीबर्थ ही नहीं हुआ है सो एग्जैक्टली सो इफ आई थिंक एटीट्यूड मेक्स अ लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंस सो स्टार्ट having that attitude and when it comes to attitude I didn't mean you disrespect someone you make a comment on someone you try to laugh on someone or you or like belittling like lot of people do in a corporate professional world they try to belittle someone if they have more a good set of skills or I would say a good set of compensation as compared to them.
Right.
Attitude means we need to have that attitude in our mind that nobody has a fucking power to destroy us.
True.
Especially emotional, physical and mental health. These are the things which we can keep a close tab on. Ourselves. I don't need a counselor and a psychiatrist until and unless I'm not permitting them. If I can control my emotions, if I can keep a close tab on my mindset, if I can control my thoughts, nobody has a bloody, I would say, I think itna kisi ka audacity nahi hai ki koi kuch bol de. Pehli baat. Second thing, when it comes to finances, I do understand the graph never remains same. At times, we would see ourselves at times we could see ourselves low.
I myself,
I have a very lesser experience. I may not, maybe having a very lesser experience as compared to people who are into a session today, like 4 years of experience or 5 years is nothing as compared to a person who has been in a corporate for around a decades. But what I meant to say is they don't understand when they are getting into toxic relationships or when they need to get rid of any particular person. And that could be our friend, that could be our spouse, that could be our anybody, even our parents. So we need to understand this thing, something which is killing our time, our energy, our mind isn't meant for us. First thing. Second thing, journaling does help. I myself have been that kind of a person who really likes to read something, understand it, and then write it in a notebook. So I've been that kind of a kid throughout my life, throughout my academics as well. I never cared about it, what people think or what people are actually thinking. So when I used to be in my school days and I used to be a little fatter, so people used to make a comparisons and they used to, because I, having a bulgy arms, people used to think that, oh, this girl looks like a masculine. So I tell you what, it's all about how do you think about it, and nothing should make an impact on it.
True.
So it could be that I might be more successful as compared to them, and it could be that I might turn more hotter as compared to them.
Yeah,
so I believe that कोई है ही नहीं जो तुम्हारे जैसा है और ना तुम्हारे जैसा बन सकता है. So we don't even think this way कि कोई ना कोई तो हमेशा हमसे बेटर होगा. Rather we need to think it this way कि भाई हमसे बेटर तो कोई है ही नहीं. But इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि हमें किसी से सीखना नहीं है. We need to learn. We need to improvise ourselves. But we don't need to belittle anyone. And that's the best attitude you could ever wear. Don't give a fuck around people. Don't mess around. But then don't even mess around with your own mind. So if you think you are in a toxic relationship with your boyfriend, and if you think you are in a toxic relationship with your spouse, with your parents, and they feel afraid to be with you in a public, you need to get rid of it. And you need to understand that that's screwing your mind badly. It's a great mess and you need to work on it. So modernity does have an impact, as you said earlier as well, comparison, success factor, failure factor. And then we talked about the emotions, we talked about the mindset, we talked about positivity, negativity. What are your views around, what are your views about being cool and uncool? I've seen a lot of people tagging each other. Yaar, tu to bahut cool hai because tu daru peeta hai ya tu chutta maarta hai. So what are your views around?
एग्जैक्टली पता भी नहीं कहाँ से ये सारी चीजें मतलब हमारे अंदर आ गई यार. मुझे एग्जैक्टली कोई आइडिया भी नहीं है कि मतलब कहाँ से ये सारी चीजें यू नो फ्रॉम वेयर दीज थिंग्स हैव कम इनटू आवर सोसाइटी. कि वी आई डोंट नो यार, शायद लोग इतने फ्रस्ट्रेटेड है मे बी इसलिए कि वो अपने काम में खुश नहीं है तो वो कहीं ना कहीं अपने आप को खुश करने की कोशिश करते हैं. यू नो दे फाइंड देयर ओन एवेन्यूज टू मेक देमसेल्फ फील गुड बिकॉज दे आर नॉट फीलिंग गुड इन देयर जॉब्स or in the kind of work that they are doing. So basically it's like I would say kahin na kahin khushi dhoondni hai yaar. To alag alag cheeze har koi pakad leta hai aur fir har kisi ke paas apne reasons hote hain. Aap reasons sunoge na bade absurd reasons log dete hain. I enjoy it. Yeah. I mean, how can you enjoy it? I mean, I'm not saying that I am all clean guy. I do certain things. I know that. I don't have any shame in accepting those things, but I don't say that these things are cool. How can you say that? Smoking is not cool, man. Smoking is not at all cool. It's an addiction. अब हुआ ये कि हमारी सोसाइटी में हर चीज जो भी बुरी थी ना, जिसको हम कुछ टाइम पहले तक देखते थे कि खराब है या तो उसको हमने कूल बना दिया है. तो the day we have stamped those things as cool, तो अब वो फैशन में ट्रेंड हो गई हो. अब वो ट्रेंड बन गया है कि अब हर कोई वही करने पे लगा है. क्यों? क्योंकि सारे लोग वही कर रहे हैं. Everybody else around us is doing the same thing. So we have also started doing the same thing just because we want to fit in, you know, those societies or those
basically. Yeah.
So right.
I even you know, the same type of an opinion I would have here, Vipin, because I don't think so that if he doesn't smoke, if he doesn't drink, or if he doesn't have, you're not into any thing, you are uncool. First of all, do comment on this that you are not living up to the expectations of the society which have stated you, which have made you caged into that world. But I feel that this is also our mindset. I don't think so that, you know, if I'm not drinking, if I'm not smoking, I'm uncool. I'm way cool. It could be that I party really harder than them. So it's our way of celebrating life. And it's a way of celebrating ourselves. So, मेरा ये मानना है कि हम, I'm not saying now there is a big disclaimer as well. We would like to give to our followers and audiences. We are not commenting on smokers and on drinkers.
Yeah, not at all.
Those who do are uncool. Even I do drink, and it's not.
Yeah,
like
even
that.
I do but that sometimes.
Exactly. But we meant here is that we don't need to keep those things. With a tag. We don't need to use them as a tag of someone being cool and uncool. So someone who doesn't do it, better you don't say that to that person again in a future that you are so uncool because it doesn't do this. Mm. You need to
basically don't make them look inferior just because they are
inferior,
not doing a particular thing that you are doing. Right.
Exactly. So here our only intention of, you know, talking around the aspects of modernity, especially into smoking and drinking, I think among millennials, because we guys are into corporate world and we guys attend to attend office parties and, you know, hanging around our boyfriends and girlfriends. Yeah. So we are totally, we are not saying that we are against anything. It is just, please do not use those words, I think the modest word would
loosely.
Don't label someone with do because that's really discourteous. So if you really because you know, Vipin, I totally believe that we millennials are future generation.
True.
We guys are future generation. We guys are bloody making, we guys are bringing change into the leadership, into all aspects of life. So we need to understand that this thing that being a millennial generation, we guys are responsible for a lot of changes which we can do in terms of economy, in terms of everything. So it's good to be cool. It's good to be uncool as well. And it's good to be drinker. It's good to be a non.
And by the way, who are making these definitions, first of all?
And it's we. Because it's we humans who actually detroit other humans. So it's
true.
we who have made those labels, and then we have tend to use them defining others, and then the cycle has keep on going on, and that's the reason
that's
we
true.
Are actually harming someone somewhere, maybe in the past,
right.
present, or future. So we need to recognize. So it's a need of recognition, and we need to recognize this thing that no,
right.
we don't need to think that way. We do not need to put these words in a in
right.
labeling someone, in defining someone, and हम लोग यहाँ पे कुछ ज्ञान नहीं बांट रहे हैं, but it is
yeah,
just
yeah,
the
yeah,
need
yeah.
of recognition. It is just the need
true.
Of recognition. So I feel we millennials are that much mature and sensible that we can understand कि हम लोग को modernity के क्या aspects लेने हैं और क्या नहीं लेने हैं.
True, true,
everyone
true, true.
Likes westernization and westernization is cool. But
then
we need to understand lot of factors and parameters which are attached to it. So that
That's
shouldn't
right.
we shouldn't be doing something which is hampering our own mindset, our mind. And
yes.
in nutshell, we are Detroit in terms of emotional, mental, and in terms of a stability as well. Finance
right,
ka to chhod do. Because
right.
I understand finance health ka graph kisi ka bhi same nahi hai. There could be my friends who might be having more package than me with the similar years of experience. And
right.
there could be someone who could be having a low compensation as compared to me with the same span of a journey and a time in,
right.
you know, in corporate environment. But
right.
emotional, mental is something, physical is something I am responsible for. And
right,
I need
exactly.
to work upon how I can improve myself, how I can improve our, and improve my own mindset, my own life. Because I am bloody charge of my life. Nobody else's.
That's true. Right.
And I
exactly.
think everything is roaming around it.
Mm.
Whatever aspect we talk about, which is, you know, inculcated with modernity, modernization.
Yeah, central theme is exactly the same.
This is the central theme that it's we who are responsible for everything
right.
around. Second thing, it's our mindset. We need to control it or else the mind will keep controlling us. And then we say ki yaar life achhi nahi hai. लाइफ पर अनुकूल कोई हमें गोवा पटक दो. गोवा में ही सिर्फ लाइफ नहीं होती है. सो दिस इज आल्सो
या आई हैव सीन लाइक यू नो पीपल टॉकिंग अबाउट दीस थिंग्स एंड बेसिकली हाउ आई सी इट इज लाइक दैट यू नो दीस थिंग्स आर वेरी रिलेटिव. यू नो इफ यू आर फाइंडिंग पीस एट वन पर्टिकुलर प्लेस इट्स अ रिलेटिव पीस. हाउ कैन यू कॉल इट पीस? इट्स रिलेटिव पीस इन रिलेशन टू दैट पर्टिकुलर प्लेस. यू विल फील दैट पीस until and unless you are at that place, and the moment you go to your native place, you'll again
you're again back to that,
back to the
right.
square one. Yeah.
So I see a lot of people have commented on our live, and it good to know that people are enjoying, and a lot of people have stated that we have been there and so relatable.
Yeah.
conversation
actually people can relate to this. Yeah,
exactly. I can see a lot of people are relating to the context which we are using, and we are glad to
right.
see everyone's comment, their ideas and opinions, which are always welcome.
Right,
so,
right.
Vipin,
there is
okay.
one thing that I want to ask you, one thing that I want to bring forth. As you have
yeah.
mentioned about the corporate world, just to tell you that I haven't like experienced it at all in my whole life. I never like gone to you know to
Been,
doing any job and I've never been to that place.
हाँ
मैंने जो भी करना था वो खुद से किया. But you are experienced. You're way more experienced than me as far as corporate sector is concerned. How do you think you know that particular corporate sector plays with our minds? You know at times the whole structure and the you know whole politics game. I've heard people saying about these things a lot, that there is like you know whole hell lot of politics that goes on in a you know corporate sector. So how do you cope up with that, and what have you seen in your own life? You know, if you could share some of your experience.
A very great question, I would say, Vipin, and
thank
there
you.
Is lot to talk about, but I would try to debrief myself
right,
over
right,
here
right.
at this point. First of all, yes, it's very true, as we have already talked about toxicity, and
right.
we mentioned that it's at work as well as in our personal relationships. We need to shore up what type of relationship we have with others, and if people are happy with our success
right.
or not. The moment you realize that person hasn't been you know, contented with your promotion or with the tag which you have got next.
Right.
Get rid of that person. And there is a simple way to get rid of with that person. Always limit your conversation. So if I tell you, if I give my suggestion, how I handle this toxicity game or politics game at work, if I recognize that my relationship with my coworker or with any of the person at work is not affirmative or is not positive, it's not going in the direction I want to be, I'll delimit my conversation with that person. It's not that I directly say something to that person. I just simply start limiting my conversation with that person and be sure of what ideas you're exchanging with another person. Right. Because that everyone is interested in your idea. So whether you're an entrepreneur, whether you're a business person, whether you are a working professional, make sure that you share your ideas, your future goal, your long-term goal with someone who is really interested to know and who is really interested to see you over there.
Who basically feel happy in your own happiness.
And I think this is something very quickly we understand and we recognize when we start talking with someone. There is something we always say we have heard of, even vibes. Yaar, meri uske saath vibe match kar gayi. तो मैंने उसको सब बता दिया या बताना पड़ा या जो भी है ना. सो दिस इज वन आई डू. आई लिमिट माय कन्वर्सेशन. आई एम एन एक्सट्रोवर्ट पर्सन. आई बिलीव इन द पावर ऑफ अ नेटवर्किंग एंड आई थिंक वेयर एवर आई एम टुडे इट्स बिकॉज ऑफ माय पर्सनालिटी, माय एटीट्यूड एंड द पावर ऑफ नेटवर्किंग. आई नेवर बिलिटल एनीवन, बट आई ट्राइड टू मेक यूज ऑफ एवरीवन एनीवेयर आई कुड. So if I see that any of my friend is good at something, I myself implemented and proposed those ideas to him or her. Now, why don't you do that? Why don't we collab like this? Why don't we work towards it? So we need to start adding these things in our conversation.
Yeah, let's collab. I personally think that it's a very great idea that you mentioned, that you yourself, you know, you yourself go out and, you know, talk to people about it and you propose ideas, because there are so many people who feel shame in doing that. How can I go to that person?
They feel shame in doing that, but see, this is the power of a networking. This is the power of a networking. So we both have collaborated together to have a pep talk on this subject matter, because one is our area of interest. Second is, I think, the collaboration. And third, we recognize each other's skill and art. Of conversing and of being able to talk on the subject matter given. So I think this is something I do. I develop images, as this is my niche, and I try to do a lot of collaboration through the power of a networking. And I believe my community, my circle, I am very selectively available. So this is in me that I try to go around with people who have a purpose to live. I'm not saying people who have a purpose to earn billions, you know, but I mean a purpose. Maybe a purpose to, you know, work on themselves, a purpose to have a good job, a purpose to work
and basically they are, if they are curious about things, you know, that curiosity has to be there.
तो मुझे लगता है वो जिज्ञासा कभी मरनी नहीं चाहिए. और अगर मैं किसी के साथ घूम रही हूँ तो बंदे के अंदर बहुत जिज्ञासा होनी चाहिए. वो मानना नहीं चाहिए. मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि अगर आप क्यूरियस नहीं हो, तुम आप लाइफ को अच्छे से जी नहीं रहे हो. नाउ आई एम नॉट लेबलिंग समवन बीइंग अनकूल एंड यू नो कूल एंड अनकूल टाइप, बट मुझे ऐसा लगता है अगर आप क्यूरियस नहीं हो तो आप सीख क्या रहे हो.
व्हाट एग्जैक्टली आर यू डूइंग इन लाइफ देन?
आप किसी में भी हो ना. सो आई थिंक यू as a person, you might be having a great community of your photographers and your creative directors. There could be a lot of people who have numerous, you know, amount of art skills, and you can collab with them. You can boost their energy. You can turn that vibes into positivity. You can, and you would feel good. That will impact your own health, and that will impact your, it could be that you might not earn something, but you're emotional, you're physical, mentally, you would feel very strong as a person. So this two things I do. One is finding a good set of people for networking. Second, limiting my conversations with toxic people.
That's very
and
necessary.
Just say hello, good, great, have a great day. Because I believe in being nice.
Yes.
We are nobody to improve someone. Until and unless that person doesn't improve themselves.
True.
So better you all be always bless everyone and let them be who they are. So this is my way of actually, you know, giving a fuck out to someone by simply limiting my conversations with them. And that's a signal to them. If I am not doing energetic conversations with them, because me being a personality, people know I'm energetic. I like to talk. I have a purpose and I like people. I love them. I adore their personalities. And if I am limited in a conversation with you, so kahin na kahin pe that's a signal to them that I'm not up to my own with you.
True.
And that's the
and
big.
I can see that. I can see that in this conversation as well. Like we are probably talking with each other, you know, for the first time like this.
And first time in life, and we are not judging each other for anything.
And और मुझे लग भी नहीं था कि मैं पहली बार बात कर रहा हूँ. ऐसा लग रहा है कब से बात करते हैं, आराम से जानते हैं दूसरे को बहुत सही तरीके से. And this is probably the first time.
Great. I think it's the great compliment if I am able to collaborate with you in a positive way and see how amazingly we have boosted each other energy and how fantastically it has worked on our mental health. And maybe I think this has made our Sunday very, very productive, and we believe this is the same for audiences as well. So this is something of you being, you know, full-time professional. One is delimiting myself. Second is recognizing needs. And third is the power of networking. That's the mantra.
Amazing.
Because I believe that there is a lot of goodness around us. Intangible and tangible assets, both. So finance ka language.
Exactly.
Why na? Tangible, intangible assets. Hum dono ko use karte hain acche se.
Right. So we were talking about, you know, we have been talking about these things like modernity, depression, anxiety, all the psychological issues. I mean, I want to ask you, and it's a very direct question, and I want you to comment on this because I know you can do that. One thing that I really want to ask you is that, what do you think, like, are these things, are these psychological issues inevitable? Are these the price that we have to pay for modernity, or to, you know, to get westernized or to get modernized in this culture? Is this the price that we have to pay no matter what? We cannot escape it. Is this is the way, or is there a way so that we can keep our sanity and keep ourselves, you know, safe from all these things? What do you think really about that?
Honestly speaking, Vipin, I don't believe that we have to pay price for anything.
Okay.
I mentioned in my previous conversations as well, and during this live session, nobody has the audacity to make you do something which you're not willing to do. First thing.
Right.
Second thing, even if we are a millennial generation and we are tend to following these modernity aspects where we talked about smoking, drinking and getting ourselves into hookups and flings, you know, one thing I would like to comment upon, that nobody has a bloody audacity to make you do something you're not willing to do. So be it, even paying price for modernity, no. If modernization says that, you know, big smoking is a cool way, is way of living life. For me, there are many different ways of being, you know, living a cool life, and I'm bloody living it. And I can define that, I can demonstrate that, I can lead you with that purpose. So I'm not paying the price there for the modernization or for the modernity. This is something I don't think that it's inevitable. Right. Nobody can make you do something you're not ready to do.
Great point.
It's your emotions, your thought process, your feelings, your mindset, your intelligence. I think your attitude, your personality, all these elements make you. You are consist of all these elements. So if you work upon your mindset, if you work upon your emotions, if you work upon yourself, if you work upon your feelings, emotions, mindset, positivity, negativity, everything. Nobody has an audacity to even spread negative power around you.
Right.
So even if that seems an attitude to someone, wear that attitude today, in the moment, now only. Because nothing is inevitable. Nobody can make me drink if I'm not ready to go. But
great
if
point,
I am in a modern
point.
Party.
Excellent. Excellent point. I really love that.
If
I, love
I am
that.
In a modern party, nobody can deliberately do that with me. If I am not willing to, and if somebody is trying to make me drink, then I am permitting that person to do that with me.
True.
So it is what you permit others. If I am suffering from a breakup, I have permitted that person can really trigger me, can really play with my emotions, can trigger my feelings. So there and then, when I'm not giving an audacity to that person to even not triggering with me, nah, that person cannot do anything to me. I do understand that we relationships are very tender, though that's not our agenda for today, but since we have talked about this thing, relationships are very tender, very sensitive in nature. I do understand that feelings and emotions, it takes an effort to nourish, nurture something.
Right.
But if I am in a toxic relationship, nobody has committed to be in that relationship. I can move out of it if that is triggering me badly. Because if I will not do that today, I may not be able to lead the purpose life tomorrow. And if you think you don't have a choice to get rid out of it, talk about it. I feel second thing, which I even when you talked about how do you deal with toxicity or politics,
I
said I delimit myself. I'm not who I am with people I don't want to be. That's my attitude. And that's what I wear. I'm not what I am with people I don't want to be. I don't want even them to think about me. I don't want even them to even study me. They won't graduate anyway. Anyway, they won't graduate. So this is an attitude I wear.
Right.
I have my own control with my mindset, with my with you know feelings and emotions. Nobody can trigger me easily. But okay, it could be a instance I have been in a relationship or I am in a relationship and that somehow breaks out.
Right.
We are not able to nourish it, nurture it. Nobody has asked me to be in a toxic relationship. I need to recognize the signs of toxicity. And either way, if I cannot break it, I need to talk about it. So, mujhe aisa lagta hai ki communication is the solution for everything. If you have a problem with someone, talk with that person. First, advice. I won't even say advice because people take this word also, you know, in a very different way. So, I am not use this
they
word.
They think ki koi professional, bol raha hai aur ye points hai.
Exactly. What I do, if you talk to me, something I don't want to break. I want to keep in my life. Any relationship and friendship. I talk. I communicate that thing out. And if that doesn't work even after it, then I'm really sorry. I cannot really do something about it.
Right.
And I've been given a choice of it, so I have to get rid of it. So your goals are your fucking life.
True.
And you need to improve on yourself for yourself. You are not doing that bloody for anybody else. So when people say it's inevitable, you know, modernity, when people say that you are in a club and you are in a lounge, you need to be with a sexy guy and you need to have a bottle of a beer in your hand, and you need to wear a lot of makeup because you tend to do that. I feel it's a personal choice.
Right.
Be comfortable in your skin. Be comfortable in your own attitude. Because that's an individuality. We do not need to forget. We don't need to forget to celebrate individuality in terms of modernity.
True.
I am enjoying my individuality as much while having a pep talk with you on a live session with our community.
Right.
So this is our way of celebrating ourselves. This is our way of celebrating life. And that's what it is. We are not even inevitable to pay the price for any modernization or westernization. Well, nobody has even asked us to do that. So that's the way it is. That's the way how I deal with it.
I love all the points that you made.
There is no mantra, Vipin, honestly speaking. People say, na, we will go to Pandit, ke paas jayenge, things will work out. Hum log, let's go to the psychiatrist and we take that, you know, parenting counseling and we take that relationship counseling. Fucking nothing works that. I have studied emotional intelligence and I know tools and techniques, but honestly speaking, it's all about you. And if you
Basically, you just want to talk. So find a good person with whom you can talk.
And I think more than that, talk with someone you have a problem with. I think things would be sorted there and then only.
Directly go up to them and have a conversation with them.
Exactly. Right. So if I have a problem with someone, I need to directly communicate with that person. Things would be sorted. If that's not working even after it, I'm really sorry that nothing could ever work on it. And maybe that's something written because I am a follower of a destiny as well. Everything goes with the flow. So if something which is not working, even after making an efforts. Oh, great. I myself is a follower of a destiny. Wow. So that's how it is, you know. Something which is meant to be will be there. Something which is not meant to be will never be, no matter what. And everything can be improved. It's just our mindset. Everything can be improved. So that's all, you know, I would like to say out of my experiences and opinions and maybe the stories. And our story could be anybody's story. So I think it's good that we talked about our fears. And I'm really glad that you talked about the person you were 2 years back and the person you're enjoying your individuality at this moment now. So that's really great.
It was amazing.
Really. So we've been, I would like you to give some at least 5 tips that could really improve your all, you know, your all over individuality, personality, anything like, you know, like I said that I delimit my conversations, I am not myself, few people, so anything you practice in your daily life.
First thing would be to become more aware and more conscious of, you know, whatever that is going inside your head and whatever that is going around you. Become more aware. Don't be ignorant of things. You know, don't just shrug things away and say that nothing is happening and, you know, I'm all good. Address issues. Have the courage to address those issues. Be conscious and aware of whatever is happening around you. Don't be a dummy. Don't be a robot. Become human. That's the whole point of being a human. So one thing would be become more aware and conscious of it. Meditate, I would say. One thing would be write. Just write as much as you can. As much as you can. Because when you write, basically what you're doing is all those thoughts that are in your head in like fragmented way, in fragmented realities, you're putting them into words and you are actually channelizing them, you know, at the right place. And you're giving... You are joining those things, you know, basically you're joining the dots now. So you will have a clear picture of what exactly are you thinking and what exactly you need to do in order to get rid of that particular thing. So writing would be one thing. And then reading books. I mean, I don't know why people don't think that reading books is also cool. I think it's amazing. Spend time with good readers. There have been so many good psychologists, philosophers, artists who have written so many amazing books.
Great things.
Amazing books. They are like gold mines. Why don't we just read them? So I would say one thing would be read as many books as possible if you have time, of course. And another thing would be just keep on developing new skills. Keep on developing your skills, you know. Yeah. Keep on learning new things. You know? Keep on adding on to your arsenals. I don't know if I've said that thing right or not, but learn everything. Whatever you want to learn, just keep learning them. If you're interested in photography, do photography. And I've seen one thing that I really want to like talk about is, I've seen people saying that I want to become this. I want to become that. I want to become this, I want to become. Why do you want to become something? You don't have to become. You just say, I want to do it. I want to do photography. So do it. Nobody is stopping you from doing it. But the moment you say that I want to become a photographer, now becoming happens in somebody else's eyes. When the other person is not giving you that kind of, you know, vibe, when they are not actually acclaiming your talent, how can you become something? So I would say, instead of becoming something, try to do something. Because doing is in your hand. Becoming is not in your hand at all. If I want to become a photographer, I cannot just, you know, do photography and say I have become a photographer. If I want to become a photographer, somebody else has to tell me that, oh, you are a good photographer. You are a photographer, basically. Then I will become a photographer. So I need, you know, outside, I would say, validation in order to become something. But to do something, there is no stopping. I mean, no, nobody can stop us. So do anything. Learn photography if you want to learn it. If you want to learn editing, learn it. If you want to learn writing, learn it.
So yeah. I really liked it. Really, you know, the number one tip which you gave about journaling. Second thing was recognizing. Right. Need for recognizing. I really liked it that we don't need to be ignorant about things around us. But then we need to recognize negative, positive. Right. Then journaling them, working upon them, recognizing need. And apart from that, working rather than thinking when we work. So becoming a feature of who abhi karne ka wo ek jo cheez hai. That needs curiosity. That needs passion. Right. Karne mein focus.
Right.
So this is something I really liked it. Ki hum jab kuch is karne ki koshish karte hain, we tend to take outside validation. Mujhe lagta hai that why do we even need validation from people? I like training. I like coaching. I like people. That's why I do it. Do I need somebody validation how good I am at? No.
Exactly.
I don't need it. I don't need it. I don't want their opinion. I may take people professional advice or improvement tips that you could do that way next time and you could work more better with the flow or maybe with this set of questions and you should be avoiding these you know, particular selective words. But they are nobody to tell me what I could become, what I cannot become.
True.
First of all. So I don't need somebody's outside validation. This thing I would say cut off from your dictionary. Stop taking people validation. Stop asking them, you are looking beautiful or not. You are beautiful. See it in the mirror, the person you are looking at. So this is like, this destroys your brain badly when you start taking validation, because what you want to do, I think, you know what you want to do. So you need to actually own your own decisions.
Right.
And I believe if you cannot, you know, cannot be the owner of your own decisions, what exactly you're doing in your life, because your life is the decisions you're making. So if I am putting myself into the job, into the certifications and into other things parallelly, which I'm doing, because I really liked it. One thing you said, learn and unlearn and upskill yourself. This thing is very important. So if I'm doing that, I don't need somebody's validation, whether I'm doing it right or not, or if I am on the right track or not.
Exactly.
So these are the amazing tips which I like, and it does help and work out. Working on your mindset, journaling things, and really setting up goals and taking action towards it.
Right.
So I can see that. I can see that in you. Or you can see that in me. And we both can feel the difference we started. That's when we, you know, when we started recognizing the need. So we could feel things. We don't need somebody's validation to do this life. We wanted to do it and we are bloody here. So we are not taking anybody's validation out of it. Should we or should we not? Because we think this is a need of an hour, and that's why we have done it.
And that's why we're doing it.
And, there is no bad of it. We are not harming anybody. Right?
Yeah, yeah.
So I really liked it. And I would also like to follow the tips which you have given. And I really liked it reading thing, because I've actually heard it somewhere that when you read, you live multiple stories.
Right.
So if you're a reader, you have already lived a lot of stories. You have lived people's lives.
People's lives. When you are so many people.
Reading, when you're just reading yourself, you're just reading yourself.
Right.
You are not living people's story.
Perfect.
When you're reading, you're living a lot of multiple personalities, a lot of multiple people. A lot of multiple right. people are residing in you. So we're not talking about Atmas over here, guys. Don't be scared.
We're not talking about multiple personality disorder at all.
I think the third disclaimer. So अगर लोग ये सोचे कि भाई वो बुक पढ़ के उनके अंदर बहुत ज्यादा आत्माएं आ जाएंगी तो ऐसा कुछ नहीं है बट वी जस्ट टेंड टू यू नो थ्रो सम लाइट ऑन दिस दैट व्हेन यू रीड एक्चुअली यू लिव अ लॉट ऑफ लाइफ ऑलरेडी सो यू एक्सपीरियंस लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंट थिंग्स व्हेन यू स्टार्ट रीडिंग समथिंग सो अमेजिंग टिप सो आई थिंक देयर इज वन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम वन ऑफ द पर्सन एंड आई वुड लाइक you to take that okay how they can you know how this person has written how you can improve your own mindset if you constantly think about negative what are your views about mindset. That if you
just
constantly
just become aware of it. The moment you become aware of it, you can see it exactly what is happening in your head. The overthinking happens because we are constantly, you know, looking out for the solutions outside. We are not actually, I would say, working on the problem in that you know scenario. We are always trying out different things just to ignore that particular thing. You know, so many people like they travel compulsively, they shop compulsively just to ignore that particular problem of their life. But the moment you become aware of it and you sit with yourself and you ask good questions to yourself, you will automatically find solutions to it. Okay, something happened.
I think some technical glitch. I got out of the live conversation.
No problem.
Yeah,
no problem.
I couldn't you know, hear your last, I think, 2 minutes of speech.
So I was just saying, just become aware of, you know, whatever happening. Just don't ignore your problems.
So recognition is important, and recognizing your grassroots is important.
Yes. If you are feeling any changes in your body, in your mindset, in your like heartbeat, and any physiological changes, if you're feeling, just become aware of it. Don't run away from them. Don't you know, find petty things to do just to you know, ignore that particular problem of your life, which is like the pressuring point of your life. Don't ignore that, because the more you ignore it and the more you, you know, keep yourself busy doing certain things, busy traveling and, you know, shopping compulsively or partying compulsively. Don't do anything compulsively. You don't have to run away from things. Just become aware of it. Sit alone. Ask yourself good questions that why, what exactly is happening with me? What exactly is the real problem that I'm running from? The moment we stop running from our problems, we can definitely find solutions, because we are like, we are living in an information age right now. We have tons of information at our hands. So we can find any kind of solutions by ourselves. All we need to do is just become aware of things.
That's it, I would say. So we are the owner of everything. So we need to we need to actually validate with our own selves only. We don't need to validate from the outer environment
True.
Or from the
True.
Outer people. So really like, so there is someone who has also mentioned that thank you so much for, you know, talking about all these things, because they have felt
basically, where are these questions? Like, I'm actually I'm unable to see these questions. I don't know why.
So there could be some technical glitch, but I could see in my conversation. So they have written that one of the person has also written that, you know, glad that we have talked about all these things, because people feel reluctant and they don't feel open talking about all these things. And the main reason is judgment. The moment they will talk about all these things is that people would start judging them. So that's the thing. We need to get rid out of it, that we need to be... We need to actually make people stop judging ourselves. So it's we who are giving adversity to someone to do anything with us, maybe against us or for us. So here we would just like to now, thank you so much, guys. I could see a lot of people joining in.
Thank you so much, we are grateful
for each one of you to be here.
I don't know why I can't see any of those comments.
Yeah, there are a lot of people who have recently joined. I think that's from your community, maybe. It's a person from outside, I think, outside India. I mean, there's Bukhar, something like that. Okay. So, we would just like to say thanks to each and every one of
you.
Thank you for being here and listening out our conversation. We are really grateful from the core of our heart. And thank you so much, Vipin, for doing this live session with me. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So here we would like to say goodbye for the evening.
And thank you, Vaishali. I would like to thank you. Thank you so much for doing this live session with me. It's been an honor talking to you. Amazing conversation.
Same here, Vipin. Amazing. Same here. It was an honor, to be on a platform and to know your community and to know your thought process about everything. Thank you so much for giving out this opportunity to me. All right, to call out for an evening now. All right.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, guys. Bye-bye. Thank you, everyone.
Take care.
Bye-bye. You too.